never gonna wear these again. Like, I am gonna wear them. It's just, I'm not supposed to spruce them up. So, yeah. That's what I'm deciding to do with them. Hashtag DIY. Hashtag lit Friday night. Yeah.
The Celts. But nevertheless, these Celtic boys in the last war were named the ladies from hell. So you have to be terrible careful if you ever get curious about the Celts.
Oh, don't worry, when these all dry, I'm doing the back. I'm never gonna wear these again. Like, I am gonna wear them. It's just, I'm not supposed to spruce them up. So, yeah. That's what I'm deciding to do with them. Hashtag DIY. Hashtag lit Friday night. Yeah. Question. Serious question. Should I paint it just solid? All the colors, or just leave it the way it is? Please let me know, because I really do need to know and start that. It might help it dry a little bit faster, but I'm not sure. I doubt it, but we'll go with it and see. So.
Mom, get up! It's time to go to school! It's Halloween day! And this for you to wear. Hope you enjoy it.
I'm a dinosaur!
It's time to go! It's time to rock and roll!
I'm not wearing this at all.
Yes, you are! Put it on! Come on, let's go. Put it in the car!
I always give in to him.
Yeah!
Happy Halloween!
Come on, we're gonna be late. Let's get in the car. I'm not even going to school today. I'm good.
And I can put it in a bun. And I can put it in a bun. I got my edges back.
Where are we?
At school.
What? Oh no. Oh no. Freedom! I'm free! I'm free! Yeah! Pumpkin! Wow, look at this guy's pumpkin! I love it! I love this logo! The pumpkin! The pumpkin! Yeah! Ah! Ah! The ocean! Oh my god, it's so cold! Man, I'm having so much fun! Oh my god, oh my god, oh god, no! Ah! Help! Ah! Look! Football!
Alright, Don, go long!
I got it, I got it, I got it! There it is! There it is!
Here comes the cootie squad. We should
shut up! Shut the fuck up! I don't care, alright?
I'm sorry.
No!
I'm never gonna wear these again. Like, I am gonna wear them. It's just, I'm not supposed to spruce them up. So, yeah. That's what I'm deciding to do with them. Hashtag DIY. Hashtag lit Friday night. Yeah. I'm never gonna wear these again. Like, I am gonna wear them. It's just, I might as well spruce them up. So, yeah. That's what I'm deciding to do with them. Hashtag DIY. Hashtag lit Friday night. Yeah.
But nevertheless, these kilted boys in the last war were named the ladies from hell. So you have to be terrible careful if you ever get curious about the kilts.
Oh, don't worry. When these all dry, I'm doing the back. Okay, question. Serious question. Should I paint it just solid? All the colors, or just leave it the way it is? Please let me know, because I really do need to know and start that. It might help it dry a little bit faster, but I'm not sure. I doubt it, but we'll go with it and see. So, yeah. That's better.
It was summed up when soon after Show was sent down to developmental to sort out some issues, and that's not really what happens
better.
After you've been WWE.
The same damn
almost
thing,
done.
Because it was the idea in the first place that sucked. It's like a paper raincoat. No matter how many times I try and sell it to you, you're still going to get wet.
Do two layers.
Would like one, please do get in touch.
I'm quite tired, though.
I'm quite tired.
Quite tired.
Flops WWE should never have tried again. Number 10, bragging rights.
Okay,
in 2009, WWE made two errors. The first was the pay-per-view known as Bragging Rights, a team-based show, which was going to air a month before Survivor Series, which is a team-based show. I don't think we have to go any further on this.
The
second was the basis of the idea.
Number one, a doppelganger feud. We just mentioned Kane, so let's go all in with that as well. Although we'll start with SummerSlam 19.
Bed. Yep. Let me show you what my pants look like finished. I just have to take the tape off. But I will do that in the morning. Dressed down Friday next week, I'm wearing them. Hell yeah, I'm so excited. It's gonna look good, I'm excited. Next Friday may not be a good idea though, because we're going out in public. So yeah, that may not be a good idea, but we shall figure it out. And yeah, I'm exhausted. My allergies are bugging me and I'm going to bed. Good night, guys. Deuces. Hey guys, what up? Oh, I just want to show you a big ass leaf, but I can't get to it. That's pretty damn cool. Anyway, I will just gonna switch it around for a sec. Yeah, I got new colors this time. DIY projects. Just kidding. Obviously I'm not, but still. I'm very excited because now I get to go home, clean up my room again, blah, 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 you know, the usual. And then I'm going to do my garland, and I'm so looking forward to it because I had white up on my wall at one point during the week last week, and I didn't have enough, so it was ridiculous. So, yeah, let's go, shall we?
ਨਹੀਂ ਪਰ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਤੁਰਨਾ ਪਤਾ ਇਹ ਗੱਲ ਮੈਂ ਕਿਉਂ ਕਰ ਰਿਹਾ ਇਹ ਗਲਤੀ ਮੈਂ ਕੀਤੀ ਸੀਗੀ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਕੁੜੀ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੂਸਰੀ ਕੁੜੀ ਨਾਲ ਸੈਟਿੰਗ ਕਰਾਉਂਦੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਨਾ ਉਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਹੀ ਕਰਨੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੀ ਉਹ ਉਸ ਕੁੜੀ ਤੇ ਟਰਾਈਆਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਾਰਨੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੀ ਉਹ ਬਾਅਦ 'ਚ ਸੈੱਟ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਹੈ ਕੀ ਦੂਜੀ ਤੇਰੇ ਕੋਲ ਛੱਡੀ ਸੀ ਹਾਏ ਬਹਿ ਜਾਓ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜੀਜੂ ਨਾਲ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਿਹਾ ਨੇ ਠੀਕ ਹੈ Oh. ਮੇਰੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਪੁੱਛਿਆ ਹੋਣਾ ਉਹਨੇ ਕਿੱਦਾਂ ਐਮ ਜੇ ਬੜੀ ਤੇ ਸਾਲੀ ਝੂਠ ਮਾਰਦੀ ਸੀ ਜਾਣ ਕੇ
wondering, actually, I just took off the tape on my leggings that I worked on last night, this morning, and I will show you how they turned out, because I think they turned out pretty damn good. That's just my opinion, but there it is. Okay, so you guys remember how they look, right? Looks, I should say. Alright, so let me flip it over. So top layer, middle. As drunk could be. This is them. And their completed stage. I have a bracelet that I found, like from the studio, that I'm actually gonna fix up because I have a white paint that I'm gonna do and fill in the letters. Maybe doing an umbrella side, just white on both sides. White on both sides is the way to go. Because that's the new umbrella. Kind of looks like spray paint. Nothing a little white paint can't fix. This is actually one of the best. So that's done. Yep. Back to blue. So now, what do you think is going to happen next? I'm going to do two sets of lights here, I think. So pretty that I just want to do it. I don't know, like it was long enough. Could actually wrap around with her. Yes. I'm just gonna leave that. I'm tired.
But for whatever reason, they insist on using this probe as a little attempt to elicit heat. Number five, Brock Lesnar, the final boss.
Two different sets of lights on there. You know how happy that makes me?
Is over. Number four, the slap shot. It does make sense in the...
Guys, just started my next DIY project. I taped the front, I painted it white. I'm gonna go in with a second coat of white, or a third, or a fourth, or a fifth, who knows. Okay, so don't mind me. I'm gonna take this fist. I'm kidding. Alright. Now, let's hit play because I'm going to watch Alicia.
I'm going to stop rambling. And also, again, I'm going to say it again because it really is just so serious to me. Like, I'm going to talk about some numbers, but I also don't want that to, like, affect you guys in any way, shape, or form. Please know that the scale or any number, like, does not define you whatsoever. I feel like it's taken so long for me to learn that. And there's still times that I struggle with it. Like, for instance, I weighed in this past week at, what was I? 157. I feel like in my head, I always thought I'd be, like, low 140s. Like, I had this, like, this number in my head that I thought I would hit. it and I'd be so happy. Where like now I'm like, no, it's really not about that whatsoever. And the funny thing is I went into this whole journey at 163. When you do that math, like there's hardly any like weight loss technically, but what I've done is like I've made that all muscle now. But I had a moment, just like most people would, of seeing that number being like, oh shoot, like I know I'm not supposed to care about this, but at the same time, like I kind of care about it, even though I shouldn't. So yeah, I even had that moment of being like, Alicia, like you shouldn't care, like practice what you preach. But you have to remember, like, it's not just about a number, it's about how you feel and everything. And I feel so much better now. Even today I did some cardio sprints on the treadmill because we decided to kind of change some things up because I was doing the same thing for like months. And my body was so strong. It was tiring, but it was not exhausting like I thought it was going to be, because it was like just sprints every 30 seconds. And I was able to like kill it. And I was just thinking, Alicia, like before you would have never been able to do that, and now you are. So that was really cool. I feel like right now I'm just in this kind of time of being consistent. I even talked
and we came prepared.
Oh yeah.
So what do you think
about it this week, because I was having a moment of just feeling like I wasn't exactly where I kind of wanted to be. But we had a really good talk about just how things really do take time, and a lot of people expect, especially fitness, to be an overnight thing, or be even in 3 months. 3 months is not a long time. But yeah, overall fitness has been good. I feel like I've definitely been killing the workouts. I've noticed my body gets so much stronger, which is really exciting. I normally do training like 3 times a week pretty much, and then cardio Monday through Friday at least. This sounds like a lot and insane, I know, but I just wanted to like be real with you guys. Why am I rambling so much? But yeah, that's all fitness. And then food-wise, food's so interesting because it's just become so ingrained in me to like bring snacks with me everywhere. So I still eat 6 to 7 times a day. Every time before I work out, I have a little split, which is either just like jelly and peanut butter, or the split packets that I wear. Oh my god, the split packets that I use all the time. Also, if you guys saw my main channel, you know, the initial video that I did about my weight loss and fitness journey and all that stuff, I mentioned how I see a nutritionist, Dr. Golia, and he has an app actually that I didn't use at the time. My mom did, so I saw how she liked it a lot, and then I ended up using it maybe the past month and a half-ish. And it was so funny because even though I still obviously have appointments and go see them in person, I really, really like this app. And it's so funny, it could just be a personality thing, but if you guys are like me, like I need structure. For instance, I don't need to go in every week, but I like doing it just for my own self to like know and have that accountability. Where Ashley, for instance, can easily like go every few weeks, and that's still good for her. I'm the complete opposite. I like going in all the time. So I downloaded the app like a month and a half ago, and the main reason why I did it was because I knew I was gonna be traveling a lot and I wouldn't be able to make those appointments. And I really, really like it. I don't use it religiously as much as I like could, but again, because I go in every week, I don't feel like I need to as much. But when it comes to traveling, like that was so nice for me. Here's the thing, I feel like most people have 1 or 2 vacations. I travel so much for work. Sorry, even though they look like vacations, 90% of them are still work. So and changing my focus to just being healthy and eating right because I want to for me and my body was the biggest thing ever. I'm just so thankful that I was able to, I don't know. It's hard for me to update sometimes because I feel like I have to explain everything that I've already said in other videos that might be redundant for some of you guys. And then also at the same time, I know that there's new viewers and stuff, so I'm going to have my initial video links.
Thank you.